First thing is we gotta drop this under tray, and we're gonna do that by taking out all the fasteners and then just dropping it down. All right, so my car is an NC1, and to take off just the center under panel, we're gonna be undoing all the bolts along the front here. And then there are a few kind of push pins or push rivets here and there. You'll see them wherever you see them, take them out. Over here, there are actually three fasteners that hold the side of this cover on. So you can see the holes here, 1, 2, and 3. And the same on the other side, 1, 2, and 3. So you have to get all those fasteners off, as well as the ones that are on the bottom along the front bumper to get this cover off. I did actually pick up an RX-8 front sway bar, and since this is really easy to reach right now, I'm gonna be swapping this out. The new RX-8 red front sway bar is in, and I couldn't record while doing this because I had to use both hands, but let me talk you through what I did. I undid obviously the brackets, I removed the bushes, and then I undid the headlight level sensor, just this bolt here that attaches to the control arm. And then I undid the sway bar links from here, and I left them attached up on the sway bar themselves. I just undid this with an impact wrench, and then did the same on the other side with sway bars. And then I also undid this bolt and moved this bracket out the way. This line, I think, is for the speed sensor. And that's it. Once you've got those done, you're gonna basically have to wrestle against these rubber hoses for the coolant, and perhaps a couple of the rubber hoses for the power steering system as well. Basically, you wanna try and get the arms of the sway bar. You wanna turn it from, looking at it from here, you wanna turn it counterclockwise and get this arm up and over this tie rod and out here. Once it's out here, you'll have to push up and press, kind of almost crush into the rubber hoses. And while it's all the way up, you're gonna feed it down down that space, and you're gonna pull it out this side. I find that just because of the positioning of all the hoses, it's actually easier to pull it out from this side, which is the left side of the car, the driver's side if you're in the United States. And when you're putting it all back in, it's easier to insert it from here over to the other side. Another tip is make sure your links are on the right way around. I realized I had mine the wrong way around after getting it all in, so I had to undo those bolts, which is pretty hard to undo without an impact wrench. I had to undo them and then turn them around or switch them, switch the sides. The sway bar itself doesn't have an orientation left or right, but the end links do, so you want to make sure they're on the right side, on the correct side, I mean. So there we go.